Okay, next exercise. This next exercise is almost identical, but now we're throwing in a pull vector constraint that allows you to control which direction the knee is aiming. Okay, guys, take a quick look at my screen here. I'll go through all the steps and I'll start over again. I'm selecting any bone and I immediately switch to X-ray mode in the armature menu. Now you can see through. I already created a constraint for you. There's already an IK constraint. And guys, check it out. The handle's already working. I've selected that knee point, the bone's hovering outside by the knee, and you can see in the bone menu, I named it knee pull target. So by selecting the lower leg bone and going to the bone constraint menu, you can see that the pull target's attached, and when I hit G, that'll allow it to swivel, okay? Now, I'm just gonna go back over this. Nick, you just had an issue where your parenting was a little bit messed up. Here's how I recommend doing it. Even though you're supposed to select the mesh first, because it's a child, I'm selecting any bone, and I just make sure that when I select it, it defaults to pose mode. That's all I'm doing. Then I select the mesh, hold shift, and select the bone, control P. And I'm not choosing automatic weights in this case, because this guy's gonna be like a robot. He's got separate joint, separate body parts. Okay, so for this next exercise, after you bind everything, I just want you to move the leg around for me and then show me that you can change the direction that the knee is pointing. Okay, I'm grabbing the IK handle. Now I can control the direction of the knee.
Excuse me.
You don't have to apply any constraints.
Okay.
Go ahead and select the mesh here. Okay, and then hold shift and select that upper leg bone. Exactly. Do control P. And then choose bone. Okay. Grab this control and hit G. And then you do it around. Nice. Now I'm going to select this mesh, hold shift and select the lower leg bone. Yep, control P
and choose bone.
Now select this kneecap. Which bone should this kneecap be parented to? The upper leg or the lower leg?
Upper.
Yes. But actually, it's a trick question. It doesn't matter. It could be upper or lower.
All right.
Okay. Okay, we have a lot of other lessons, so I'm going to just move to the next one. Here's another leg. It's a different bones. I'm gonna skip this one, okay? I'm gonna skip number three because I don't think it's necessary to go through this process again. I'm gonna skip to number four. This is more of a modeling exercise. How could you get this orange model to be a little more rounded and have more volume and be less linear looking?
Subdivision.
I would probably just switch to edit mode and hit Control R. And then hit S to scale it up a little bit. Okay, so the calf muscle should have a little bit more volume up at the top. And hit Control R, slide the loop up. Hit Control R again. Scale a bit. All right, in this next exercise, there's a lot less of the work that's completed. Okay, I'm gonna switch to X-ray mode, and you can see that I've got a leg. It's like a pant leg with a knee pad on it. Some camouflage pants here. Okay, guys, please just take a look at my screen. I'm just going to go through this as fast as possible. I'm going to switch to the armature menu, and I'm going to switch my bone type from octahedral to stick, so it's a little bit skinnier. Okay, I'm gonna switch to pose mode, and this IK handle is already broken off. It's already named. What's missing is the pull vector constraint. So I'm gonna switch to edit mode, and look, I'm gonna extrude out an extra bone here. Just like we did last week with the worm, how do we break off this bone? How do we unparent it? Alt P, good, Alt P, and then clear the parent. And I'm just going to move this forward a little bit, and I'll call this knee control. Using the bone menu to name it. Okay, you got to switch to pose mode if you're going to apply the IK constraint. Okay, the chain is 2. The pull target is going to be the armature again, but we're going to choose knee control. And look at how, once you apply that knee control, your leg gets rotated 90 degrees. So you got to switch over to your pull angle and just average it to the nearest 90 degrees. It could be positive 90 or negative 90. Okay, the leg is slightly bent. So I'm going to go into edit mode. I probably should have manipulated these bones before I applied the IK constraint.
You can manipulate them after though, even after skinning, right? Like,
yeah, because I wouldn't do it after skinning.
Yeah, I ran into a problem where I would do a chain for like a finger, for example, and some bones, even though they all look like they were pointing in the right direction, I can control them and realign them individually, but really act, truly act. And I noticed in that process, even though I'd already skinned like the hand, I could still readjust the bones in edit mode, and they'll pick up right where they left off. I mean, they were in a
That's awesome. Yeah, that's really amazing. I wouldn't have expected that. Okay, now I'm gonna select the mesh, hold shift and select any bone. This time, because the leg isn't in separate pieces, it's just one huge mesh, I'm gonna use automatic weights. Okay, now I'm able to move the leg, change the direction it's pointing here. Maybe I have to rotate the foot a little bit.
You know, those braces people have on. You got both here.
I'm gonna start all over. Step one, if you switch to material or texture mode, your texture is gonna be totally dark, so I'll hit Shift A and just create some lights around it. I'm creating 1 point light, and then I'm increasing the energy to make it really bright, and then I just hit Shift D to duplicate this lamp and place a bunch of lamps around at varying heights as well. Okay, after switching to material or texture mode and then adding lights, I'm gonna turn on X-ray. After I turn on X-ray, I'm gonna choose a different type of display. You don't have to use these octahedral shapes. You could use stick, B-bone, envelope. You can try out these different views. I'm gonna choose stick. Okay, switch to pose mode, I'm sorry, switch to edit mode, and then I'm moving to a side view, orthographic view. From side view, you can see that these bones don't really line up very well with the mesh, so just use move tool, hit G, and just adjust your bones a little bit. Check out the configuration of my bones. They fit nicely inside the model now. Any questions so far? Your leg looks like it's kind of off.
Right.
So switch to edit mode for your bones.
So let's see. If I try to match it exactly where it is, then
wait. Did you already bind it though?
No.
Okay. Then how did the kneecap get offset if you didn't bind it yet?
No. When I bind it, right.
When you bind it, it
does the leg, but not the kneecap. So I'm wondering if maybe the kneecap has to be separate from the mesh.
That didn't happen to me. Well, let me complete the process and see if it happens again. Okay, now I'm gonna select this lower leg bone and I'm gonna apply the IK constraint. See, Nick, I don't know how your knee pad got offset because I haven't even skinned it.
It's pretty interesting, huh?
Did you move the leg at all?
No.
How did this mesh even move? That's my question.
So yeah, I go between my head and walking out.
How did you move the mesh?
You probably moved it.
Just move it back. Just move it back in edit mode. Did you bind it and then unbind it? It looks like you moved that whole leg over there. Okay, let me complete this process. Tyler, it looked like your kneecap got offset as well. I'm not sure how that happened. Okay, guys, you need a knee point. So I hit E to extrude while in edit mode. Did you guys create this knee pointer yet?
Yeah.
That might give you more information for Vindu. So guys, really important that you select that knee bone and extrude out, and then clear the parent to break it off. Okay, don't forget to rename it. Yeah, I'll change the look of my bones so you can see it better. Okay, here's what I got so far.
Switch back to pose mode first. Now select this one. And hit one in front of you. And just slide it over so it's lined up. Right here, you control it. Let's see what the choices are. There's one more choice. Yes. And then pull target. Choose armature again. And then which one? Multiple choice. Yes. Awesome. Okay, now let's select the handle. Up one. Chain link two. Okay, have negative 90. Thank you.
that stays on.
Alright.
Nice. How come your knee pad's not staying on? How come your knee pad's not staying on?
Oh no.
That's hurt. It's weird. It's for some people, the knee pad's not staying on.
I was like, wait, that's the mesh.
Okay, guys, I'm gonna go on to the next exercise anyway. I'm not gonna do this one. We can come back at the end of class. This is a different type of leg. There's like a knife strapped on, and there's more stuff on the leg. Okay, we'll deal with this later. I'm gonna move on to a new topic. Okay, raise your hand if you've animated a walk cycle in any other program before. I know you have. Okay, all right. I'm gonna just show you guys a really simple walk cycle formula. Okay, guys, take a look at my screen up here. So far, I've got three columns of keyframes in the dope sheet. Let's check this guy out. There's only three columns, so I'm gonna move to frame 20. And what happens if I hover over the timeline and hit the letter E?
Ends there.
Whatever frame I'm on becomes the end. So currently the frame range is 0 to 50, but I'm on frame 20, so if I hit the letter E while my mouse is over the timeline, my new frame range is just 20 frames. I'm gonna hit play. Look, this guy's just sliding. His feet are just sliding. Okay, what's wrong with the way I'm walking right now?
I'm not pushing the ground anymore.
I'm not changing my height as I walk. All right, that's huge for a believable walk cycle. So look, when your feet are closer together, between 0 and 10, right in the middle of these two columns, I'm gonna grab the hip and watch, I'm just gonna raise it up a little bit. Then I hit I to insert keyframes, boom. I got some new keyframes. Then I'm gonna go in between these two columns when the feet are closer together. I'm gonna raise this guy up a little bit and hit I. Now watch the sliding. Now there's a little bit of up down motion. Okay, what am I gonna do next? Well, I'm gonna go back to frame 5 and several. What am I gonna do with this foot?
Raise it?
Yes, I'm just gonna raise it so it's not sliding. And then I hit I to keyframe it. When I go to the middle of the other two columns, I'm gonna select the other foot and raise it a little bit and hit I. Now let's check out my walk cycle so far. Now it actually looks like he's taking steps, he's moving up and down. The only thing left is the arms are kind of weird. So the first position in side view, let's have, if the left foot is forward, how should the left arm be?
Back.
Okay, we're not like walking like stereotypical Russian soldiers, right? When one leg is forward, the other arm is back, so I'm gonna hit G and just move it back a little bit, and hit I to keyframe. I might as well just select the other hand at this point. I'm gonna select all the bones by hitting A twice and keyframe them all. Okay, now I've gotta swap positions. And I can just copy and paste this whole column. If you click on the top keyframe, it'll select the whole column. That's really important. So I just hit Shift D and I can overwrite this whole column.
Oh, because it's the same right in the middle.
I forgot to keyframe it. I moved it, but I forgot to keyframe it. That's a really, really basic walk cycle. And I'm just hitting the letter I to keyframe. Let's try this together as a group. Please open a file called walk1 marshmallow. I just call this guy marshmallow. Okay, step one, go to frame five. Just go to frame five. Okay, on frame five, hover over your 3D view and just hit the number three so you go to side view. Please just raise the hips up so that this character is a little bit taller. Okay, hit the letter I to set a keyframe. Next, go to frame 15 and do the exact same thing. Raise the hips a little bit higher so the character is a little taller and keyframe. Now just hit play and you can see that the character is at least bobbing up and down a little bit. Okay, after you raise the hips up and down a little bit, I forgot to mention, shorten your frame range from 0 to 20 instead of 0 to 50. One quick way to do that is just go to frame 20, and while you're hovering over the timeline, hit the letter E for end. So I'm hovering over the timeline here, I hit the letter E for end. Okay, it's up to you what you guys want to do next. I'm going to go to frame 5 and raise this right foot a little bit and then just hit I. Then I'm going to go to frame 15 and raise the other foot. Okay, I'll say that again. On frame 5, that's in between the two main positions, I'm just raising the left foot up a little, or the right foot up a little bit. Any questions? Tyler, are you done?
Yeah.
Let's check it out. Alter it. Oh, nice. Oh, yeah. Shorten the timeline. Okay, I'm just going to interrupt you guys and go to the next exercise. It's okay if you're not done, because walk number two is big head. It's the same type of exercise. Okay guys, this next exercise, if you just hit play, you'll see the character sliding his feet again. This is a totally different rig. The rig's totally different, but the concept and the steps that we're going to do are exactly the same. We're going to start by raising the hips. I'm going to frame 5. Side view, I'm going to raise the hips a little bit. Keyframe. Go to frame 15. Raise the hips, hit I to keyframe. I'm also raising the feet. But guys, check this out. There's one thing I'm doing a little bit differently. When I raise the foot up, guys, keep watch. When I raise the foot up with G, I'm also gonna tap R and rotate the, well, I'm also gonna tap R and point the toe down a little bit. Because this character has got a little bit more detail than the marshmallow guy. The marshmallow guy didn't have feet, he just had like stubs. He had stumps. Okay, what else is different about this character? What else is different?
Fingers.
Okay, yeah, there's fingers. There's one more important, very important detail.
I'll pull back first.
The marshmallow guy had IK controls for arms. I can't control for a walk cycle. For a basic walk cycle is sometimes a little bit more complicated. It's way easier, in my opinion, to just rotate the shoulder back. When you're doing a walk cycle, sometimes it's a lot easier to just rotate the arms with FK controls. Selecting all and then keyframing. And then I'm gonna copy and paste. I'm gonna duplicate all those keyframes and just check out this guy. I'm gonna close my T panel and the N panel. Alright, now I got a basic walk here. Alright guys. You can add more nuance, you can add some head movement, you can rotate the hips a little bit more if you want to. Okay, if you're putting weight on one leg, tilt your hips towards the ground, towards that leg that's actually where that the tilt the hips towards the weight bearing leg. Okay.
See where the shoulder is. Notice I might as well precede the shoulder and then the leg pops. Almost like the shoulder.
Oh, okay. Yeah, exactly. And opposite. Uh-huh. It's opposite, yeah. And I mean you can give them more swag, whatever. When that happens, it's just because, my first position is like this, okay? If you guys ever animate your walk cycle and it turns out the guy's walking backwards, the reason why is because when you go to frame 5, instead of lifting this foot up, you lifted this foot up. And then on frame 15, you lifted the right foot, that's all. Okay. All right, guys, I want to switch to the next exercise because it's almost exactly the same. All right? Please watch my screen. This next one is, in my opinion, one of the most important lessons today. All right, in this next walk cycle, we got a brand new character. The rig is a little bit different again, but again, the walk cycle formula is the same. I'm going to rearrange my windows. Just to review how to change your windows here. I'm gonna push this up and then I'm gonna split it horizontally. And down in the lower left-hand corner, I'm gonna switch to Doshi. Okay, check this out. Instead of setting columns of keyframes at 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, I'm gonna go to 12s instead. Okay, look, I'm going from 0 to 48. Okay, please watch carefully. This is something new that's gonna speed things up a lot for your walk cycles. Guys, I'm making my window a little bit wider. I'm making it so much wider that you can see these three buttons here. What does this icon look like? There's a clipboard. Yeah, it means copy. And if you're in pose mode, you can copy it and paste poses. And the third button over here, this third button is paste flipped. All right, check this out. I'm going to copy the pose. Let me select all my bones. I'm going to copy the pose. Then I'm going to click paste flipped. Boom. I'm going to make sure I select all the bones, all the controls, and hit I, the keyframe. Then I'm going to go to frame 24. Select that first column. Copy paste. And let me just hit U real quick. Okay. I got that sliding motion a lot faster now. This is the beginning of any basic walk cycle for me. I follow this formula all the time on my own. Is I just create this sliding movement. And it's all it is just copying and pasting that first pose. You create that first pose, just copy that pose, go to the next column, whatever your timing wants to be, paste it, but flip it. Then duplicate that first column again. And you get this three column starting point. All you have to do now is go in between, raise the hips, raise the feet, rotate the foot if necessary. Look, I can even copy and paste the hips. I'm duplicating, boom. Let's raise this foot up. Rotate down. Keyframe it. Go to frame 6.
Copy.
No, because it's the other foot. Back to the arms. Okay. That's a good starting walk cycle. Obviously, this is not a good walk cycle. It's far from finished, but it's a good rough draft. And I was able to get to this point in just 2 minutes or less. Okay, it's all about getting started as fast as possible. All right, I'm gonna start all over. Let's try this together as a group. I'm opening up walk number 3. Okay, I'm gonna collapse this top window. And I just wanted to review splitting your layout, because it's really important to customize your layout however works best for you. And also, sometimes you open up other people's files and you need to adjust the layout yourself. So you gotta feel comfortable, and I wanna make sure there's no questions about that. Okay, adjust your views so that you guys can see these three buttons down here. Just copy by clicking on this first button with the clipboard on it. On frame 12, use the third button to paste the mirrored pose, and then hit I to keyframe all of those controls. So after you hit I on frame 12, move to frame 24. I'm hitting Shift D on that whole first column. Okay, so I get that sliding motion.
Okay, so leave that one, switch that one to Dope Sheet. Third one up. Yep. Okay. Hover over that vertical line right there and just slide it over. Okay, good. Hover over here and hit T and N. Okay, good. And you can see those copy and paste buttons. Oh, you already did it. Sweet. Okay, select that top button. Yeah. Select the keyframe there. And then Shift D and slide it over to frame 24. So Shift D to duplicate that whole column. Shift D. Oh, okay, I see what you're doing. That's cool. Yeah, you could move the, I see what you're doing. That gives you at least a target to where to move it. So now hit Shift D. And then use your mouse to slide them over. Well, you clicked, so they just went. So keep your right hand here. Hit Shift D with your left hand. And then use your right hand and just move the mouse. Yeah. All right, that's just some walk cycle exercises. Check out FX Dojo for Blender classes.